afternoon. Today we are basically discussing the same issues, the P versus NP and NP hard, NP complete, unsolvable, exponential, P space problem. These are the problems you will come across in your data structure and your algorithm class. So I just repeat once more that you have already done it there. So this is you, if you see that this is your complexity more the way the complexity comes, and this is the P notation. This is the P problems. Don't you think that even in the P problem, that is, everything is solved? Not at all, because within the P problem you always strive to make it more better algorithm, like that insertion sort is n square algorithm, selection sort is n square algorithm. But whether they are both same? No, not at all, because insertion sort is much better algorithm. Selection sort, both are n square algorithm. Selection sort is worst algorithm. Because why? Because selection sort, if you give the best cases for the selection sort, again it will take O n square, because it will again compare, it will take the always the minimum and then put it at the left, and again put it, go for minimum and put it on the left. So this is the worst algorithm, even it is worse than bubble sort. Both are n squared. So there is always a research work, even the polynomial problem, to reduce your complexities. Then we have found in 1960s quick sort, which is much better than Mart sort. Though theoretically you see that quick sort is O n square algorithm and Mart sort is n log n algorithm, but quick sort, most of the, even 99% case, it is n log n, and in not only n log n, it is much quicker. So that is the reason it's called quick sort, but very few cases it might go O n square algorithm. So that is the reason the theoretical upper limit is O n square, that is we sometimes call the average complexity. So even if it is a P, within the P there is always a, computer scientists try to make it a worst case scenario much better, and like, though worst case is quick sort is worse than Mart sort, but most of the cases quick sort is better. So there is always a research topic. Then there is another peculiar topic is here. This is a typical NP complete problem, and within this there is a gap whether this is a P or NP. So most of the problems we are now, that like primality detection by AKS algorithm, which is right now, it was thought to be a non-polynomial problem, but 2004 our scientist, one of them is Dr. Professor Mahendra Agarwal, who is also right now estimating the COVID deaths. He's a very famous mathematician and computer scientist. So he and his students has proved it, that the primality detection, that whether the number is primer or prime number or not, that is called primality detection. This primality detection is a polynomial problem. So there's always a topic here, some problems goes to here, some problem is proven to NP complete. So like this. So these are the areas is vague, and this is one of the very research topic whether P is equal to NP. Most of the computer scientists believe that P is not equal to NP. And this is the NP complete problem. NP complete problem, what is NP? NP is not polynomial, that definitely not that, because most of the people's things after sometimes you might forget that it might be not polynomial. No, it is not. It is that a non-deterministic Turing machine can find the solution in polynomial time. That is NP. It picked a big name. But what is the beauty of this NP complete problems, that it is difficult to find a solution, but once the first solution is found, it can be checked in a polynomial time. So that is great, like our Sudoku. So it is difficult to get the solution, but once you have one solution, you can check it. That is NP complete problem. That is another famous problem is three-sat problem, satisfied problem, click problem. That is what is the maximum click size, and that is Hamiltonian path is there or not. But there is another version of the problem that is difficult, that is called NP hard problem. What is NP hard problem? NP hard problem, it is basically not a decision problem, it is a optimization problem. Like whatever problems we have discussed in computer science is basically optimization problem and decision problems. And I have told you again and again that any optimization problem, like optimization is you want to find the value of particular variable for 1.2916, that is how much close you can get. That is optimization problem, and another is decision problem, whether the value is less than 1.3 or greater than 1.4. like these are the things of the decision problems. Most of the optimization problems can be converted to decision problem. Decision problem, NP complete problem is basically decision problems, but NP hard problems, mostly they are in that is a optimization problems. So NP hard problem, the question might be asked the Hamiltonian, the minimum path, minimum distance in Hamiltonian path. Whether Hamiltonian path exists or not, that's a decision problem. But what is the minimum weight like this? That is called the NP hard problem. Then it is whenever it is given, it can be checked. But whether that is the lowest one, how can you check? So this, that is a difficult problem. Then more difficult problem is the exponential problem. Typical example, your chess, because every piece of the your check have multiple number of moves, maybe 8, and it can go anywhere. So even in the midst of the play, if you suggest a Vishwanathan Anand that this is your winning move, but here, but that is also checking is also take exponential time. So that is a, but that is all solvable problems. That is the exponential problems. Then comes that same problem is Turing decidable. Turing this that is a type 0 language. Remember these all these complexities can be you can have similar problems our language, context free grammar language, like P problems. These are all regular language problems. All regular language decision issues are all P. Even the context free grammar also, because in context free grammar you see the maximum parsing is O n cube, so it definitely is a P problem. But the problem of NP complete, NP hard, it comes from our grammar angle, because we right now have three diagrams at least. The concentric circles diagram, one is from the machine section, that is the automata section. The automata section, the innermost is the combinatorial circuit. Definitely that is equivalent to regular language. Then comes combinatorials, that is the combinatorial circuit, the minimum, that language is the finite. But whenever you go for infinite language with some feedback, that is called finite state machine, which is a superset. That is infinite language. That is interesting. Infinite language like a to the power m, b to the power n, m is m and n has no relation. This is called regular language. We have, and these are all proven in 1930s, 40s, 50s. In the meantime, the Turing machine comes 1936, 37, which is basically a revolutionary concept, because at that time not a full-fledged research has not been done on finite state machine. Then 1950s comes the pushdown automata, 50s to 60s the pushdown automata, then the Turing machine is more being revealed, and that's it. So all this complexity, this one, and there is another concentric circle here. You can see it is a P problem, this is NP, and this is NP complete. This NP complete is very interesting. I have told you it is around 3000 problems. It is discovered in 1971-72. Till the problems are either coming NP complete or comes to P. Interesting. Then NP hard, I have told you, this is your optimization problems. Exponential and Turing halting problem with the ultimate end. That is the hardest problem, no algorithm. But that is not the end of the day. Anytime this active research is going on all along the complexities, that's it.